Hello friends, I am Dr. Prashant Sharma and you are watching MEDICO'S Hub. In this video on dental anatomy, I am going to discuss a question: describe the morphology of primary maxillary canine. The primary maxillary canines are highly sturdy and usually the last one to be lost. First evidence of calcification of primary maxillary canine appears at 17 weeks in utero. The enamel or crown is completed by 9 months of age. The eruption of canine appears by 19 months of age and the root is completed by 3 1/4 years of age. The overall length is 19 to 20 millimeter, in which the crown is 6.5 millimeter and about root is about 13.5 millimeter in length. The mesiodistal diameter of the crown is about 7 millimeter. The mesiodistal diameter of crown at cervix, it is about 5.1 millimeter and the labiolingual diameter of the crown is about 7 millimeter, which at the cervix becomes 5.5 millimeter. Now we'll observe the primary maxillary canine from various aspects. First of all is labial aspect. This is the labial aspect. The crown, the mesial and the distal surfaces are more convex. The cervical region shows that the tooth is narrow. Incisally, there is a large, well-developed single cusp, which is longer and sharper than the permanent maxillary canine instead of a ridge. So there is a single cusp. We can observe that this is the cusp and it is large-sized and well-developed. Then, if a line is drawn through the contact areas of the primary canine, it would bisect the line drawn from the cervix to the tip of the cusp. That is, contact areas are not at the same level in the permanent canine, but here contact areas are at the same level, like this. Now, the mesial slope is longer than the distal slope. We can observe that this is the mesial slope, this is the distal slope. So distal slope is shorter while the mesial slope is relatively longer. Then the root. A root is long, tapering and conical. We can observe that this is long, tapering and conical root, and length is double of that of crown. So root is double the length of crown and it is having a pointed root apex. Now the lingual aspect. This is the lingual aspect. The crown, the various prominent and enamel ridges are observed at the lingual aspect. These are cingulum. So this one is cingulum. Then mesial marginal ridge. So this is the mesial marginal ridge. Distal marginal ridge. So this one is the distal marginal ridge. Incisal cusp ridges. These are incisal cusp ridges. Tubercle at the cusp tip. The cusp tip is pointed and is having a tubercle. And the lingual ridge, it divides the lingual surface into two shallow fossa, mesiolingual and distolingual. Now the roots. The root tapers lingually and at the middle third it is inclined distally. So this is root apex, which is pointed, and the root which is tapering evenly. There may be a mild inclination towards the distal side. Now the next is mesial aspect. The crown, labiolingually at the cervical third, dimensions are greater in crown. We can observe that the dimensions are greater in crown, in cervical third. This is the cervical line. It is curved incisally. The curvature of the cervical line towards the cusp, that is, curvature is less on distal aspect and it is curving, it it is showing the curvature towards the cusp. The root tapering with its blunt tip inclined lingually. We can observe that this blunt tip is inclined lingually, evenly tapering, but the tip is inclined. Then the distal aspect. In distal aspect, we can observe that it is reverse of the mesial aspect, except the curvature of the cervical line towards the cusp is lesser than the medial aspect. Now, the incisal aspect is very important. The crown appears to be diamond shaped. The tip of the cusp is distal to the center of the crown. This is the tip of the cusp tip, which is distal to the center of the crown. And mesial cusp the mesial cusp slope is longer than the distal cusp slope. The mesial cusp slope is longer than the distal cusp slope. This is the distal cusp slope. This is the mesial cusp slope. And mesial cusp slope is longer than the distal cusp slope. This facilitates its intercuspation with the mandibular canine, which is having longer distal slope than mesial slope. So it is reverse in the mandibular canine. In comparison to the permanent canines, various ridges like cingulum, horn, cervical third, and the angles at the contact area, that is mesial and distal angles, are more pronounced and less rounded. So this is about the primary maxillary canine. Hit the like button, share and subscribe our channel to get the latest updates and notifications.